Hi, Bridge Community Church. It's Krista, Rachelle, and Lisa. We're here. We just want to share some practical things that you can do while you're at home right now in this little stay-home time. Rachelle, what do you do?
Well, I have two teenagers at home, so they're both online. They're working really hard and they're doing well, but I think for us to maintain routine is very important. Like Danny said on Sunday, he is now the principal and the PE teacher, so truly he has printed out a schedule. We have it on our refrigerator and in the kids' bedrooms, and we're flexible with it, but we try to wake up at a certain time, have some quiet time, actually take a shower, get ready, you know, kind of like you're having your whole day, like you really are going to school or to work. And so we tried to schedule that time. Lots of eating going on, lots of food prep, and lots of dishes. So that will be, you know, fun to get rid of the freshman 15. But, you know,
sure.
But we're dealing.
Lisa, what do you do?
Well, I am at home with my husband and my youngest son, and all three of us are working from home. So I've decided to set up three areas in my home. I have a work area. I'm also in school, so I'm taking college classes. I have a school homework area, and I also have quiet time out area for Lisa for devotion and just to get away. And that helps me focus. And I think my struggle right now is working through and making sure that I take breaks. Mm-hmm. And just a fun thing I've also tried to do, which actually brings joy to me, is during that break time, is to just ask the Lord to put someone on my heart to bless, and then how can I also bless myself? So last week I sent flowers to a friend, and aww, this week I bought flowers for myself.
So. Nice.
Perfect.
That's awesome. That is really cool, Lisa. I'm actually going to take some of these practicalities. Thank you, Lisa. Thank you, Rachelle. My practicals are really to find things that are already at home, since some of us can't go anywhere. So we found some balloons in our one of my sewing rooms, and I don't have a sewing room, a sewing door. Oh my, just don't have a sewing room. My house is really small. But I have balloons, and so we blew them up and we played volleyball. So I think that'd be fun for like the younger kids, because it's not like they're going to break anything. So I'm trying to just create fun within the house. I also saw Samantha Reeves. She put like popsicle sticks on the window, taped them all on, and had her small children grab them off.
Amazing.
It was cool. Very, amazing. Very creative. I think this will be a time that when we come out of this quarantine, we're all going to be super creative.
Yes.
But I do agree with Rachelle and Lisa. I am trying to stay, I haven't, but this is my goal for tomorrow, is to actually have a time frame. So if your kids are normally in school from 8 to 2, to keep them on task for mm-hmm. school, do their lunch at lunchtime, let them have that break to run around outside in the background, the backyard, if they have a backyard, if you have one. So I'm really going to try to maintain that kind of schedule where I'm doing work at the time I'm supposed to do, school at the time they're supposed to do, and then breaks at the time. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. I'm doing a lot of documentaries at nighttime somewhere. So there you go. Netflix.
There you go.
Anyways. There you go. But anyways, hopefully that'll help you guys, you know, just to try to get through this time of practicality. So we're here for you guys. Yeah. Send us your ideas too, so maybe that might help us too.
We'd love to hear your ideas. And guys, this too shall pass. We're going to get through this. We love you. We as a staff have been praying for you. Please don't hesitate to reach out to us if there's anything specific that you need. We just want to be here for you in any way we can. So we love you guys.
We love you. We're still answering the phones.
Yes.
I'm answering the phones. And we miss you.
Yes.
Hope to see you super soon.